Third game, guys. We're gonna be 2-0. Let's do this. Deshaun Jackson. I have 18 receiving yards. 329 yards. Fucking Deshaun Jackson. James White. Oh, more than you. Oh, no, maybe not. Charles Sims. But I'll get more today. Ben Roethlisberger. Oh, he threw more than me. 4 interceptions, though. I have 811 yards. Only 2 games, bro.
Hey, everybody. It's the coach, and this is Monday Night Football on EA.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over.
Cook. Yeah, let's go.
They'll start the drive with a give to White. And he spins through. And some space here. A big chunk of yardage there, 37 yards.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead.
So fast, guys.
Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he'll get 4 here down to the 35-yard line.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest game, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Here's a 4,000-yard rush.
Oh, fuck that.
And he stopped immediately there. And the tackle there by Quan Alexander.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Roethlisberger, he's going to look deep for Edelman. And this is taken in at the 5. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. The former 7th-round pick, Julian Edelman, just continues to have such a productive career.
And has made himself into a receiver. Remember, he was a college quarterback, and not just a productive one, a very good one.
At Kent State, right?
Yes, a great leader, a guy who could make plays with his feet and his arm. Got to the NFL and had to convert into being a receiver and was drafted that way. And that conversion, oh boy, it's been good.
Down this close to the goal line, first down. Surprised that wasn't a run?
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball on first down in this situation because second down, that gives me an actual run and play action, maybe throwing it.
And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. This Tampa Bay defense, they held strong on the first 2 plays. Now third and goal. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers.
Hell yeah.
This offense ready to head back out there as they'll take over with a little over a minute to play in this first quarter. Roethlisberger now off the bootleg. Head complete right side to Cook. Oh, and now he bowls him over.
That was awesome.
Showcases the spin. A pretty good gain before he's taken down. There are the numbers for Cook from a week ago. 5 catches, 54 yards, and a touchdown.
And they think they have a matchup advantage in this one. They're going to try and find some space for him to work and make sure he touches the football.
Here's a 2nd and 2 now from the 33. On 2nd down, here's Roethlisberger. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off. After the incompletion, here now, 3rd and 2. Off the play fake. Here's Roethlisberger. Flush to his right. He can run for it, and he will. Scrambling not particularly.
Hell yeah.
Roethlisberger's strong suit, but he does get the
guys,
job done there.
Big Ben was a wide receiver in college.
The category of mobile quarterback, but he's athletic enough that if you don't keep your rush lanes intact, he finds a way to hurt you.
As coaches like to say, I wouldn't call him a burner, but enough there.
Dude, you stand up before, come on.
He'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. Back with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's Steeler football to begin quarter number 2. They're looking at a 2nd and short yardage to start things out. They go play action now. Roethlisberger throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
And you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers. You know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
On 3rd down, that's White. And they'll get him down.
He's so fast, guys. I love it.
40. 12 yards that time at a Pittsburgh first. His first carry of their 2nd drive, pretty solid. And, of course, remember back to their 1st drive. Really strong throughout that one.
Not only is he getting good blocking up front, but how about his vision to find the holes? And he's seeing things before they even open and hurtling through them.
He won't let me hike it, dude.
On 1st down, it's Roethlisberger. An incomplete, crisis averted, almost picked. Instead, 2nd down.
And I picked the wrong play, guys.
So he's 3 for 7 throwing the football right now. Not an awful start, but also not the sharpest of starts.
No, I would agree with that. But if you're a confident quarterback and to play that position, you have to be. You just act like there's something wrong with the wind currents or something wrong.
Whoa.
It's not you. Keep throwing. That timing usually develops.
Another throw on 2nd down, and this one incomplete as well.
There are a good number of coaches that any time they call an in route are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver. And on that play, it was batted down.
Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. The Bucs defense stiffens and pushes this to 4th down.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on 3rd down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. 3rd down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available.
Let's go.
And this is Cook with a grab. How about them biting off 15 yards there on the 4th down attempt and keeping the drive alive?
Brandon, I have one word for you after that completion for a 1st down.
Lucky?
Analytics.
Well, the analytics say you punt the football there.
So we're changing the analytics as we go, right? What a big time play.
Oh, that would have been an awesome catch.
Really took a big time chance.
Yeah, big time first half chance. Now a throw to the end zone on 1st down, but it winds up incomplete.
I would say it'd probably be a good idea for him to reintroduce himself to his receivers at the half because they're definitely on different wavelengths. But I also don't advocate waiting that long. Next series, before you get out there. Hey, let's get together, guys. Let's get this thing moving.
It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up 3rd down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
And he'll get it down this time to the 17. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a 4th down.
He wasn't the primary.
I better make this. White, do your job.
Yeah, hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he can scatter some body.
And he's in. Touchdown.
He's gone.
James White, his 1st touchdown. 2 minutes to play in the second quarter. The offense gets ready to take over. The drive starts with a run by White. Pretty move.
That was awesome.
But he takes it up to the 40. A minute 59 to go in the first half. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend.
And he'll get that was a first.
Midfield. Let's say, yeah, they'll spot it right in midfield at the 50. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Partner, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just throwing those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
Dude, oh my god.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
Second and 10 now. It's Roethlisberger. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete.
Oh, man, so pissed.
Third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This is 3rd and 10. They go play action with Roethlisberger. Oh, a scrap.
Still has it.
And he's going to come down with it. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime.
Let's go.
Play action. Now Roethlisberger. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down.
That would have been a great catch, but real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he had been able to hold that one.
Come on, guys.
On the toss. Here's White. Dances by him. White's got a first down and more. And he'll finally be taken down at the 2-yard line. 31 yards there and a first down.
They gashed him in a big way on that last run, and defense fortunate to tackle him on the 2-yard line, but doesn't necessarily mean that there's something wrong with the defense's plan. And that's the one thing the coordinator has to do, make sure the confidence stays high. Okay, sometimes they're going to get a big play against us, but that doesn't mean we change everything.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Eric Reed. And a big turnover there.
Yeah, give my ball back.
After a good punt, this offense will start with tough field position inside the 10. Time for the Steelers offense now to get set for their first possession of half number 2. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw.
Come on, Edelman.
First down, but couldn't connect.
But it's not been the best game for him, but he definitely tried to get by with a little help from his friend there, trying to create a big play.
Couldn't do it, fell incomplete, but you're right, hasn't been a banner game here in the second half, just trying to get going.
Big thing is trying to keep confidence up and continue to fire.
One hand. A nice gain of 21 yards.
Antonio Brown, AB, with just one hand to complete that catch. Is there anything he can't do?
He has just continued to impress year after year, hasn't he?
He has never forgotten that he wasn't considered an elite receiver coming out of
college. Oh, I'm nearly done. What are you doing?
He takes it upon himself to prove that he should have been.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay, because the second part of that is, if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out.
He even fell and got back up and caught the ball.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but his horse still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Oh, and he'll just get rid of this one deep. So they turn
a good-looking throw.
Yeah, maybe even go as far as to call that a little ill-advised.
Yeah, I would say so. I think that's the right phrase for it. Definitely ill-advised. Just wonder about his mechanics right now, you know, and that's the tough part.
Whoa.
You do so much stuff in practice to make it repetitive, but it has to repeat under pressure, whether it's pressure from the defense or just the pressure of playing the game. We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
Being chased out left. So they took a shot there on
I give up.
Down, couldn't get it. Now it's four.
But no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
I'm done. That should be illegal.
Surprising move to go for it. Third quarter action. This offense will have a first and 10 as they get set for the next drive. The Steelers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. Play action. It's Roethlisberger. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you're out.
Yeah, they're not playing good at all this game.
A little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. Looking deep downfield. This is intercepted. Picked up by Chris Conte. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Back out onto the field as he'll take over here in the final minute of this third quarter. Now the Steelers offense gets ready to get back onto the field. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally.
Whoa. You're
thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. Rolling to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side.
Oh!
Play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
Even though that one was incomplete, you could see the training that went into that play. He gets out of the pocket, ends up moving to his right. All he's trying to do, though, extend the life of the play. Keep it alive, hoping someone will pop free.
Was able to take a pretty good shot with a deep ball, but incomplete. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Dude, this is like the worst game I've ever played.
Now following the interception, this offense will get another shot at it as they'll quickly head back onto the field. And the Steelers set to take the field. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead, you got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best.
And look at this.
Oh my God. Flag on who?
Picked up by Chris Conte, and he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field.
Illegal block in the back. Offense.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards.
Thank you. That's like my fourth interception, bro.
Roethlisberger now to throw on third down. Flushed out right. He gets it to Brown. Complete.
Three interceptions.
26 yards.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got a good break.
And defensively a backbreaker. Eluding the pressure right. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir, able to turn that into a positive gain. So the Steelers with a football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now Roethlisberger. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line.
First down, boys.
We'll come inside the 5 at the 4. And quickly, we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively.
Literally, my show starts at 10, guys. I'm going to have enough time.
It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. Roethlisberger going to throw it. Oh, no, he lost the football. And the Buccaneers have it.
All I know, partners, that with every play call that came in, there was a little discussion about, hey, we can seal this bad boy. We can really put ourselves in a great spot to take total control. And yet, they find a way to cough it up.
Yeah, the two-score game opportunity eludes them. And now, a chance for the other side to come back here.
This defense has to go out there and make some plays themselves. So we call sudden change. Let's see if the defense is mentally ready to take care of it.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. He'll look to throw over the middle, and it's incomplete. Charles Sims, the intended target, and it's 3rd down. So back-to-back incompletions, now 3rd and 10. And first things first, before you think about marching the ball down the field, you got to move the chains.
You're exactly right. Got to get back into focus here. Get the first down. That's what's vital to them.
And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. This defense looking impenetrable now. 3 straight incompletions are giving him nowhere to go with a football.
Oh my God.
A little frustrated back there?
Oh, there's no doubt about it. When you've
missed, I can't complain. I'm doing bad too.
Be some frustration, but now he's got to make sure that frustration is temporary, not lingering. Big throw coming up.
I swear to God.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10. Ready. Back to throw. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete. There have been quite a few plays they might look back on and say, we really have hurt ourselves, and that was another example.
And this is late game execution. Everything on the line, so it all has to come together properly. The throw's made. Where's the catch? Got to catch in that spot.
And his throw is incomplete. The intended receiver that time, Adam Humphries. And it'll bring up 3rd down. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here? Or is it just off just by a bit? Maybe.
Yes, get him down. Good job.
Situation. He'll need to.
And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. Well, the screen gets 7, but it's not enough. And it'll be 4th down. They'll look to throw. And no, it's incomplete. They had to
get a touchdown now.
Such little time remaining. Well, their first 4th down attempt earlier was successful. This one backfired. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught. Close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one possession game. This one not fully over yet.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 30.
As I make this touchdown, it is.
Right back to him on first down. Oh, nice spin.
Oh, that brought back bad memories.
And he is out of
bounds. Oh, I did step out.
Around the 10-yard line. A big pickup there, and without question, that should be more than enough to wrap this one up.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
Now, here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? Here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense. But in this situation,
no,
the hands that made the
ball, off, go for field goal.
The ball away on an attempted touchdown pass. Excellent job.
Touchdown.
And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you've still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances. Let me go ahead and show my age a little bit. I liked it when they would fake it from the 3-yard line, right? When you'd line up, go ahead, and oh, there's a fake, and he's going to get two. That's great. But from the 15, the risk reward, it's just not there.
It's so risky to get 15 yards on a fake. Well, you see the result right there.
Yeah, I know these young whippersnappers are trying to do different things in this game, but let's go back to old reliable. Kick the ball through the post.
Get off my lawn.
That's darn right.
Here's Winston. Pressure comes and the Steelers take him down. Tyson Alualu. Now the Steelers use the first of their 3 timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. So after the sack here, 2nd and 14.
I want to get the ball back.
Winston. It's caught. Humphreys. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. Now the Steelers use the 2nd of their 3 timeouts. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this 4th quarter of play. Winston to throw. He's going to let it fly. And he can't come up with a pick. Nearly his 2nd of the game. Instead, 4th down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Desperation time. Winston on 4th down. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off at the 13. Count them now, 6 interceptions between last week and this week. Now, the 3 picks last week helped them to a win. They're in the driver's seat once more.
And they're the ones doing all the leading, aren't they? Right? The 3 interceptions last week, that led to a victory. 3 interceptions so far in this game, that has them out in front. We often think of the offense driving things. In this case, it's the defense, not just holding teams.
But see if I can get a run, guys. Touchdown run.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete.
Imagine I get this, guys. Oh, my God.
On first down, the offense or the defense. Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there.
So
nice effort to knock down but away and bring up second down.
That would be cool. Game over. 2010.
Well, Charles, the forecast called for rain throughout the entire game, and we got
not a good game, guys, but I enjoyed it.
These two teams.